this test allows us to enumerate the concentration of microorganisms in a given sample or on a given surface.
Hello and welcome to Situ Biosciences Test Method Introduction Series. In this video, we'll be providing some insight about aerobic plate count testing. Please note that this video is not meant to be a comprehensive analysis of this type of testing, but rather offer basic information for customers to consider. As always, please make sure to submit a quote request, and we'll be more than happy to discuss your project's details. That being said, let's get started. First, what's unique about aerobic plate count testing is that it's not a method per se. It's a broad description for a type of test that estimates the concentration of bacteria or fungi on, for example, two commonly selected sources, surfaces and liquids. It's an exceptionally sensitive test, but like many tests that have their purpose, it also has its limitations, which we'll touch on here. If a customer submits a sample in a liquid, we estimate colony-forming units per milliliter. For testing a surface, typically the customer would send a swab with the collected surface sample for testing. We then suspend that swab in a liquid media and apply that to a solid media in order to eventually count the colonies to provide this estimated concentration. This means that this type of testing is quantitative in nature. It does not provide identification of the types of microorganisms that may be present at the time of collection. Although a customer may inquire about genetic identification or other assessments as needed. It may be helpful to consider this type of test as an environmental assessment. For example, the test surface could be a tabletop in a certain type of environment such as in a school or medical setting. Both of these environments have their own implications, some of which aren't always anticipated. This is where Situ's passion for science and expertise shines through as we help customers consider finer details in testing. For example, let's take a closer look at the test environment itself. A customer can test a given environment and have no contamination of bacteria, but then 6 inches away, the area can be riddled with contamination. Generally, what we've discussed with customers is to establish a baseline. This is because without one, the customer may have a difficult time making a comparison because of some level of what we like to refer to as biological noise, as in information that's not considered relevant. At minimum, knowing where one expects to have high counts or at least have a reference and documenting it are important. Now let's review sample submission recommendations. Customers are free to select from the many commercially available sterile swabs that will suit their needs. We recommend customers get something with a swab tip that's 1 square inch in size, and it is important that it's sterile. At most, it could include saline or phosphate buffered saline.
Hi, my name is Miranda. I am a research scientist here at Situ Biosciences, and I have a degree in environmental science from the University of California, Berkeley. Allows us to enumerate the concentration of microorganisms in a given sample or on a given surface. Testing for a total aerobic plate counts can take place on customers submitting liquid samples or potentially swabs. Liquid samples are typically plated as is, and then swabs will be suspended in a phosphate-buffered saline to actually release any microorganisms that they contain. Setup for the total aerobic plate count test depends on the sample that is submitted. A liquid sample will typically plate it as is, while a sponge or swab will be suspended in a phosphate-buffered saline and agitated to release any microorganisms that the sponge or swab contains prior to plating. So the thing that I find the most interesting about this test is that there are a variety of medias that these samples can be plated on. You can choose a selective media, which selects for a specific type of organism, or a non-selective media, which can grow a wide variety of different types of microorganisms.
That's going to do it for this video. If you've learned something today about aerobic bacteria plate counting, tell us in the comments and let us know. We encourage you to check out our other videos and our growing Situ Test Method Introduction Series playlist. Stay tuned for more, and we'll see you next time.